And it's time to talk what's happening in entertainment on the Las Vegas Strip and beyond with John Katsilometes, columnist for the Las Vegas Review Journal. Writes a column called Cats. And you're joining us today, as you always do on Wednesday, to talk about a number of topics. Interesting, Fantasy, the show over at the Luxor, right?
Mm-hmm.
Women, sexy, singers,
adult
all that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Adult Review, is that what we call it?
Okay. We call it an adult review.
Didn't realize, been 18 years here in Las Vegas.
It started as Midnight Fantasy in 2000, and it wasn't a midnight show for too long, and it has been running consistently at the Atrium Showroom ever since under the able direction of Anita Mann.
Yeah, Anita Mann. And just want to point out, this is some audition video that we shot here at Channel 13 in years past.
There's Amber Strausser.
Yeah.
She happens not to be in the cast anymore. She's a cycling instructor in town. But yeah, it's the gold standard of reviews of that type in the city.
And she's getting a big award, you said, Anita Mann?
Yeah, on Monday night she's being honored for a Legacy Award by the National Choreographers Association.
Oh.
And Anita's had a history of, she's danced in Elvis movies. She founded the Solid Gold Dance. Or she choreographed the Muppets, she's choreographed the Academy Awards show, and she's been at the helm of Fantasy for this whole time, and she's a dynamite woman.
Okay.
A great woman.
Well, Elvis Costello coming to the Wynn. Now, is this official? It's February and March? Okay.
Yes. Late February, early March, we have six shows for Elvis Costello on the Strip, and him and the Imposters, and Elvis Costello fans will know the Imposters are about like the Attractions, who were his original band when he broke in the late 70s and early 80s. A terrific artist in that theater is going to be really cool, and he talked all about how he's a big fan of all kinds of theatrical performances in Las Vegas, and he hopes to bring just a straight kind of concert show to the Encore Theater, which is going with star policy headliners ever since Showstoppers closed last year.
Tony Bennett and Harry Connick
Tony
Jr.
Tony Bennett, Harry Connick Jr., Diana Ross in the theater now, John Fogerty, those types. So we don't have any production shows there, but there's a lot of entertainment animating that room now, and Elvis is a rocker, and it's going to be fun.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. Hey, Elton John, speaking of rockers, he's leaving the Coliseum, right?
Announced
he said he's done
dates.
With his residency. Mm-hmm. We've got about a minute to talk about this, so let's talk about Elton and then the next thing of who could replace him. So Elton is announcing he's done.
He's finishing two runs that started in 2004. Mm-hmm. He's announced the last 14 shows will end next spring in May. A remarkable run, 450 shows, 1.8 million fans saw him here.
Great.
You forget how long he's played here as a consistent headliner. My feeling is that the Who were here in late July and early August this year can slot into the dates that are being left open by Elton John. There was talk about them coming back for a dozen shows. That man right there holds the cards, Pete Townsend. If he wants to come back, Roger Daltrey wants to come back there, and his voice can handle it, they'll come back. They don't want to tour anymore, but they want to play live.
Interesting.
So I'm looking for. I'm really keeping my eye on that one.
It'd be a good switchover for sure.
Great.
Elton's been great.
Same demographic.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, Katz. Thanks so much. If you want to read more about the entertainment in Las Vegas, you can check out Katz's column.
Katz.